Hi. I'm Blake Irving, CEO of GoDaddy. And I know what some of you are thinking, because I've read your tweets. It's the same thematic as last year. So I was on the Male Allies panel last year. So let me just say it. Why in God's name am I here? And what am I doing taking up your time on your stage? Aren't you the company that objectified women in your advertising for years? Sound familiar? Yes. That was GoDaddy. And as painful as it is, in the name of complete transparency, I'm putting them all on the table. Because it's important background to understand the transformation that's underway here. You know, one of my first orders of business as CEO in early 2013 was to change those ads. They obviously needed changing. But when I announced that I had taken this role to my friends, to my families, to longtime business colleagues, they responded with this crinkled up face thing and like, you did what? And for academics like Maria Klawe, who I had a conversation with pretty early in my tenure, it was even more obvious. Maria told me over the phone, she said, you know, I told my husband, in her very light, affable way, I told my husband that I was going to talk with the CEO of GoDaddy, and he said, GoDaddy? They're a horrible company. And it was all about those ads. Now, with all that said, and what's truly bothersome and what should bother all of us, is those ads brought a massive amount of business to the company. A massive amount of business, so much so that it was a lather, rinse, repeat formula that was done over and over again. And it worked. Now, based on those ads, you'd assume there was no one female in the entire company. Turns out, there was about the same number of females at GoDaddy as there were in the rest of technology companies, which isn't many, but they were there. Okay, how can that be? How is that at all possible? Well, there were two brand truths at the company, and I had experienced both of them. One brand truth was the ads, and the other brand truth was what I had experienced as a customer, where it was all about helping a small business, a very small business, or somebody with an idea do something maybe preposterous or important, but do something with it that allowed them to start off with their business. Now, before I said yes to taking this role, I had to rectify this difference. And so I traveled to the headquarters and I met people. Never in my life had I encountered a company that was so different inside than the external perception that they themselves were painting. And at the end of that visit, the truth that I found was all about these compassionate employees that love their customers. And my job as a CEO for the company, if I took it, was to scale that passion, scale that pride, build a technology platform that scales around the world, and allow more people to be able to do the exact same thing. And our customers are very small businesses. Turns out that 58% of very small businesses in the United States are run by women. So to have, you know, changing the ads was the easy part, frankly. You know, to have one brand truth, our ads needed to reflect the values of our employees and the customers that we serve. Now, This is Gwen Dean. This is a GoDaddy customer who was featured in our 2014 Super Bowl ad. Gwen Dean was a mechanical engineer who had fallen out of love with her job and had fallen in love with puppeteering. And she wanted to be a professional puppeteer and a puppet maker. So she announced in front of 100 million people on air at the Super Bowl that she quit her job. She did it. Like so many other brave people like her that decide they're going to take that big leap of faith, which are our customers, and do something special with their lives that they're passionate about. Today, her business is thriving. She actually has employees. Yes, making puppets and being a puppeteer actually scales. And we're helping her. And that's what we're all about. And you know, now the company is reflecting what I'll call our actual brand truth in our advertising, and our employees are seeing their work reflected externally, and it's incredibly energizing. The image we portray to the world now is aligned with our true identity and who we are as a company, and who our employees are in the company. Shout out to you guys. Oh, right here. Now, so yeah, we pivoted the advertising to be more aligned with who we are, but stopping there isn't nearly enough. There is empirical evidence that technology products built by diverse teams are just plain better. And as a technologist and a product guy for 3 decades, I like better. Robin Hauser Reynolds, who's the director of Code, is showing this, screening this film on Friday. I hope you all get a chance to see it. It's going to be, I think, in the Hilton. She has 2 great examples where teams of diversity weren't used, from cars to software. I'm not going to give you the punchline because I want you to go to the film. But it's amazing what a difference, a life and death difference, having diverse teams can make. So it's also true that when you see a problem and you do nothing to fix it, then you really didn't believe it was a problem in the first place. And as a CEO in the technology industry, I can't just stand on the sidelines and watch. I have to do something. So at GoDaddy, we are forging what I'll call a new path. And it's a path that is taking us step by step into a future that every talented employee in the company can be proud of. And it starts from the top. For me, it means hiring incredibly talented women and putting them into your most senior roles, to putting them into your board positions, and to make sure that they're mentors as well. And we need mentors at the highest level, women mentors at the highest level. At GoDaddy, we've recruited some incredible female leaders who have great networks. They recruit from them. They mentor others. Our CTO, Alyssa Murphy. Our CCO, Karen Tillman. Senior product execs like Deborah Weissman or Lauren Antonoff. I think Lauren's doing a session here too. They all pull people up and they pull them in. And it's incredibly important for every company to do this. Next is empowering people, always making it okay to do what is right and know it's always rewarded. For me, it meant sending a tone of empowerment around this topic. And I remember being at an all-hands meeting that we had, a room considerably smaller than this, might maybe be about half of this section. There was a group of women on my right, and I was talking about what we were going to be doing with the company, with our advertising strategy, where we're going forward. And I said, we're not going to have GoDaddy girls anymore. We're going to have GoDaddy women. And I pointed to them, and I said, and you're it. And their eyes got big, and they looked at me like I don't believe you, or that's really scary. In 2 weeks' time, a woman named Arana Wasti and some like-minded individuals had formed a grassroots organization because I gave him permission to do so and made it all right. 2 weeks' time, the GoDaddy Women in Technology group was formed. It's our first employee resource group in the company, which has been followed by four or five others. Within months, there were hundreds of members, almost a third of them male, who wanted to be part of this transformation, to have an active role, and to be able to mentor and learn. The GoDaddy Women in Technology group, or what we call GDWIT, has started to inspire others. That grassroots effort has brought us incredibly inspiring speakers like Telly Whitney herself, Maria Klawe, president of Harvey Mudd College, Madeline Denono, who's the CEO of the Gina Davis Foundation. They do great work. And a young woman named Joy Bulamwini, who doesn't know I'm mentioning her today, who's now at the MIT Media Labs, a Rhodes Scholar, a Fulbright Scholar, with a passion for computer science and boundless energy for driving positive change. All of these women, incredibly inspiring, not just inspiring the men, the women in the company, but inspiring the men in the company too, with their stories and creating awareness. Speak out. When I say speak out, it's not about asking you to speak out. It's about tech leaders in this industry putting this on their agenda and doing something about it and being vocal even when it isn't easy or popular. And did I mention I read your tweets? Now, I fundamentally believe that bad things live in the dark, and it's our job as leaders to provide transparency, to shine light where we are in this industry, as vulnerable and uncomfortable as it makes us feel. Again and again, we see that when you bring things into the light, they improve. And as a leader in tech, it's my responsibility to shine light on the state of women in technology, to shine light on real problems across the industry, and to shine a light on real numbers and the statistics. So with that said, I give you this. This is GoDaddy statistics in 2014 to 2015. Now, what I see here is kind of a positive trajectory with very, very humble change. What it says is even when you're vocal and you're putting your shoulder into something like this, the numbers move slowly. They move very slowly. We announced this today, and there's more to come. You've seen charts like this from other companies. I don't need to go through them. But it doesn't tell the whole picture. There's a lot more we need to bring into the light, and very few people have done this yet. So this past August, we pledged at the White House Demo Day to publish our salary parity numbers by gender. So let's talk salary equality. And here's a chart. Here's a chart the likes of which you haven't seen. Okay. Company-wide, and we're looking at median here, we're pretty close to parity in both technical and non-technical roles. Had no idea how this was going to land when we rolled this out and we made this promise. In technical roles, the difference is about 0.1% lower for women. In non-technical roles, it's 0.3% higher. Overall, entire company, women make 0.25% more than men. Okay, hold on. There's more. We found something, though. You know, you don't look at this data and go, oh, hunky-dory, awesome. As you start cutting the data harder, you find some other things that are very interesting. Salary parity for managers is not quite so rosy. At median, male managers are paid 3.6% more than women are at GoDaddy. And potential differences with time and role, promotion pacing, attrition, and another potential cause may be the practice of basing a new salary in part on their previous compensation. And we're describing this now as paying it backward, meaning that lower salaries are passed on as women move from one company to another company, and their salary history follows them and creates this sort of perpetuating myth, if you think about it. So, a little more detail to fill that out, and again, something that we knew from an industry perspective because we've heard about it, but now I have evidence that it exists in my own company as well, that as you climb the ranks higher in individual contributor software engineering roles, whether SDET or SDE, the population of women diminishes. Well, we posit that it might be some of the same issues with senior leaders, because these are both the most senior folks in the company, but they're there. So our commitment is to sit and sit through this data, dig, wallow in it, understand it, and come up with some understanding of what it means and what we need to do to solve the problem. That is basically shining a light on the problem in a way that can make real change. There's a lot of work going on, GoDaddy, to become the image we want to see in the world, frankly. And we're bringing it out in the light. We're being transparent, and we're working to make a positive difference. Now, this is very important to me for a very personal reason, which I will share with you. This is my sister. This is Lori Irving. Lori was a brilliant clinical psychologist and a professor at Washington State University. She suffered from eating disorders as a child, anorexia and bulimia. And Lori made it her life's work helping women fight this illness. Through her research, her passion, and intelligence, Lori became one of the foremost authorities of the negative effect on media on women's body image and self-esteem, and linked that to eating disorders. She was kind of my female doppelganger. She was my wife's best friend, and she helped thousands of people. I made a promise to her. She passed away about 14 years ago. She had an aortic dissection, and she died. And the next day, we lost her daughter, Mackenzie, as well. She was 9 months pregnant. I made a promise to her then that I'd do all I could do to advance the cause that she championed within my own chosen field, and it's led me here today. This is the work that matters. It's why we're on the earth. It's why we're alive. You know, I hope I do her justice. But for me, this is more important than a conversation about the tech industry. It transcends industries, and how we solve this challenge is going to matter deeply, not just to you, but the generations that follow you. So I'm not going to close by trying to offer you advice. I am not a woman in tech, and I have absolutely no business doing so. I do, however, want to publicly challenge my peers at other tech companies to shine a light on their practices, and I want to speak to them now. If you're a leader of a tech company, be vulnerable again and again. Learn to lift the problem from the dark. Don't hide it. Go public with your diversity statistics, publish your salary and leveling audits, and invite third parties like the Climate Institute, who is doing fantastic work to help you get some cultural sensitivity to the entire issue across your entire company. Do it. If you're a leader of a tech company, commit to top-down and bottoms-up change. Maybe even give your PR budgets that you use for diversity to grassroots organizations inside your own company to drive change instead of spin. And do the research. Find your issues and work to create an environment where all talented people can thrive. Surround yourselves with people that will challenge you and what's in front of your nose. And it was George Orwell, who I think, who said it best. He said, to see what's in front of one's nose needs a constant struggle. And it's true for my company, and it's true for every company in technology and probably across multiple industries. Now, if a company with a reputation of GoDaddy can make real progress, however slight, towards closing the gender gap and continue to put our shoulder into it, then the rest of the technology industry, the Silicon Valley, and the world can as well. The industry and the world will be a far, far better place for it. So, thank you, ABI. Thank you all for allowing me to tell our story and my story. And I'm looking forward to hearing as many of yours as I can this week. Thanks.